It's time for the PHL News Late Night Report. Thursday night, September 18th, 2014. Good evening, everybody. I'm Peter Wiggins. There's what's happening here in the top story at 11 is out in Scotland, near where Britain held its breath Thursday as officials began counting the record number of votes in the Scottish independence referendum that could end the country's 307-year union with England there. And the latest. Dundee is first for yes with 53,620 votes to nope to 39,888 votes. 352. Renfrewshire is a no at 55,466 for yes, 62,067 for no. And Inversacle, this is close for no, but it's a close race with 27,243 for yes, no, 27,329. Voter turnout 87%. There. President Obama's plan to train and equip moderate Syrian rebels exposed a deep rip on Thursday among Democrats over waging war, with a large block of liberals staunchly opposed to a modest mission fearing another long-term engagement in Iraq. Eight people, including six children, were killed Thursday in a small town outside of Gainesville, Florida. Police said that should have invited a staunch spirit. 51 was the father of an adult woman who was killed, and the grandfather of six children, Gilchrist, was killed also. Tokyo. Asian shares edge higher on Friday, cheered by news of an eye-popping initial offering of a public one by Chinese e-commerce giant Alibaba Group, while Syrian rebounded after a survey published showed support for Scotland and Maine. International agencies and government are fighting to contain the world's worst Ebola epidemic since the disease was in Nevada in 1976. Merrill Man dies in a fall from a parking garage. In Worcester, Massachusetts. And about the Florida murder suicide, the grandfather is still alive. In Tokyo, Sterling rose to a 2-week high against the U.S. dollar, 2-year peak against the euro on Friday, taking comfort from a poll showing support for Scotland remaining in the United Kingdom. A new video released by the Islamic State features John Kentil, a British journalist being held captive, acting as a spokesman of a sort for the organization. Tiffany Dixon places a rose on her husband, Pennsylvania State Trooper Corporal Brian Dixon, casket during a funeral service on Thursday, September 18th, which is today. It was 5 years ago in the same Virginia city where 18-year-old Hannah Graham disappeared. Last week, the 20-year-old Morgan Harrington was mysteriously abducted and killed. In Trenton, Governor Christian Thursday announced the selection of a veteran Democratic lobbyist and member of our former Governor Jim McGreevy's administration to lead the state Democratic of Transportation. In Phoenix, a Phoenix Sky Harbor International Airport reopened its busiest Terminal 3 hours after a man had fired a shooting suspect caused a lockdown in Terminal 4, a ground stop, and a lengthy air travel delays Thursday afternoon. Launched Jay Elson on Thursday night to Trump as chief executive of Oracal, a company founded in 1967 that has transformed the way businesses use technologies made in one of the world's richest people. Home Depot announced that 56 million credit cards were compromised in a breach that lasted from April to September 2014, making this retail breach larger than the Target 40 million card breach. Let's take a look at Stock Market Report. Eh? U.S. stock markets here, Dow Jones 72.65.99, up 109.14, S&P 500 21.11.36, up 9.79, and NASDAQ 25.93.43, up 31.24. At the risk of sounding like a broken record, that's the biggest story in the GPU industry for the last year has been over what is proposed yet. A bug in Apple's health kit, a back-end feature in iOS 8, is delaying the launch run outside developers, business, and health apps, the company said on Wednesday. That a Deadpool movie has become a holy grail for a certain kind of high nerd comic book fan. What Hollywood is cycled about the A-list superheroes, rebooting the Batman and the Superman and the Spider-Man and even figuring out finally how to create. This illustration shows a supermassive black hole in the middle of the venue. Dense galaxy M60 UCD, one where there are just 21 million suns. Annenberg, new research from an international coalition of 8 researchers suggests that killed among chimpanzees results from a noble combination, not human interference. President Barack Obama signed an executive order on Thursday aimed at promoting a new research and more responsible practice regarding treatment of bacteria with antibiotics. A spokesman for the government of Guinea said on Thursday that 8 bodies were found 2 days after a group of health workers and journalists were missed into the country. Let's take a look at what is going on in the New England alerts. This just in, just recently, a fire department in New York and Queens, car versus 3 women trapped Belt Parkway. Units on scene put in the jaws to work for the multiple occupants trapped the initial truck rescue force squad to somebody responding here. In North Carolina, Massachusetts at 55 Peterson Street, there is a company's on the scene of a working fire. At 3X Franklin Avenue, mothers reported daughter and boyfriend are trying to break into home. 94C may be involved as well as small child. In A7P2, responded to a condo street in East Boston, a patient had been attacked by a machete and shot. And in Avon, Massachusetts, hazmat commanders responded to ammonia leak at 55 Murphy Avenue. Commanders responded by the hazmat team. And let's take a look at a traffic situation at 11:06 on this Thursday night. South Beach Expression and southbound side, a little slow, you put your brain to a split. Mass Pike on the westbound side, a little slow from South Boston and Anfield, Boston Harbor. 93 on the northbound side, a little slow from the Wilmington stretch here, due to some road. Work here. Oh, yes. And take a look. 95 in the northbound side of the down, a little slow from Airport Connector, Dan Food, the Route 10 in Cranston. But otherwise, a smooth sailing come in on this Thursday night. And let's take a look at our weather situation here. Our conditions here at 9 Massachusetts at the 11th hour here. It is. Our current conditions here in North Massachusetts at 11 o'clock. 63 degrees at temperature overcast, guys, humidity 65%, wind speed variable about 6 miles per barometer, 2.10 inches, dew point about 51 degrees, and a mill speed of 10 miles. Current conditions, rain in the region here, we have 61 degrees at temperature right now, Boston and Cape Cod, Falmouth has 61 degrees, same as goes to Boston Harbor and in Milford. 55 in Worcester, 55 in Sturbridge, 60 out in Webster, 56 in Fitchburg and in Bedford, 58 in Reveille and Gloucester. It's 55 in Taunton, 63 in Norwood, 60 out in Bedford, 61 in Falmouth, 64 in Plymouth and Provincetown, 59 in Chatham, 65 in Cape Cod Bay, 55 in Martha's Vineyard, 58 in Nantucket, 64 in Block Island, 56 out in
Wesley 6-1 in Providence, 6-1 in Smithfield. It's 6-6 out of New York City, 6-3 in the slip. Today in Montauk, 6-7 in Long Island Sound, 6-1 in Bridgeport, 79 in New Haven. 52 in Denbury, 57 in Waterbury, 60 out of Meriden, 60 out in Hartford, 59 in Windsor, it's 56 out in Springfield, 54 in Amherst, 54 in Greenfield, 52 in Pittsfield, 49 in North Adams, 51 in Albany, 50 out in Maynton, 46 in Brownsburg, 50 out in Keene, 51 in Jeff, New Hampshire, 49 in Concord, New Hampshire, and in Portland, Maine, 48 in Manchester, New Hampshire, 55 in Nashville, New Hampshire, 55 in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. Here, all right, let's take a look at. Let's take a look at our map situation here. It shows a cold front from Nevada searching in eastern Idaho up into Montana. Warm front from Saskatchewan searching in Nevada, Dakotas. Merging with a stationary front from Dakotas searching in Nebraska down to eastern Colorado down for Northern Oklahoma. And a cold stationary front from Minnesota down for Iowa. And a cold front searching in the Great Lakes and down for Pennsylvania searching up into New England and up into Nova Scotia. And a stationary front from Texas searching in Louisiana and down for the Gulf States. And a cold front from Northern Florida Panhandle at the sea. Here. Photo by from Central Gulf of Mexico, searching out of South Central Florida here. And a photo by from North Central California and after Central Oregon and Washington State. And the warm and cold for Carolina out of the British Columbia coastline here. We've got high pressure up in eastern Ontario and off the Virginia coastline and high pressure. A ridge of high pressure in western Colorado, New Mexico here. And we got some low pressure in western Arizona, northeastern Nevada, southern Saskatchewan, and up and up off the Northern California coastline. 58 degrees at temperature right now in Pittsburgh. It's 69 in Washington, D.C. 74 in Atlanta. 82 in Miami, Florida. 81 in Brownsville, Texas. It's 80 out of Dallas, Texas. 61 in Kansas City. 66 in Omaha, Nebraska. 53 out in Detroit. 59 in Chicago. 63 in Minneapolis. 66 in Great Falls, Montana. 65 out in Seattle. 71 in San Francisco. 70 in Los Angeles. It's 92 in Las Vegas. 84 in Salt Lake City. 71 in Denver and in Albuquerque. It's 92 out in Phoenix, Arizona. Here. Take a look at our map situation here in Chota. Damn, a rain shows up the Cape and the Islands here. And we'll zoom out to the National Radar Outlook, and it shows a rain deluge of rain from west central Tennessee stretching into the central Gulf states, and then spotty rain showers through Texas, northern Mexico, and then southern New Mexico, and then up in the central Arizona, Atlanta, rain showers in north central Nevada, stretching in northern Utah, eastern Idaho, up in Wyoming, and up in the southern Montana. Atlanta rain showers in northern Idaho, down for west central and western portions of Washington State. Atlanta rain showers from eastern British Columbia down to Alberta, down to southwest of Saskatchewan, down to central portions of Manitoba, west central portions of Ontario, and then north central portions of Minnesota. Here. And satellite loop shows line of clouds coming from New Mexico, stretching in the middle of the southern portion of the state. And another bear cloud is from northern Nevada up into the Nova Rockets, Pacific Northwest, up in the Dakotas, up in Minnesota, and then stretching from Montana, stretching in the British Columbia coastline from British Columbia, and then for Alberta, Saskatchewan, and then Manitoba down to Western Ontario. Line of clouds coming in off New England coastline, and up in the West Central portions of New York State, and up in the Northern Michigan here.
Okay, let's take a look what's going on in the tropics here on this late Thursday night.
Flash flood threat will continue in the portion of the desert southwest and southern plains. The Pacific Northwest and northern California finally sees precipitation and remnant moisture from Odawa, still feeling heavy rains in Mexico and Texas. And a station flood will remain draped over the southeast and central Texas over the next few days. And this will continue to fire off rounds of convection and more widespread heavy rainfall will occur by the end of the Thursday night. In fact, WPC has issued a high risk for flash flooding for southern New Mexico and a small portion of Big Bend Friday evening. By Friday, showers and thunderstorms will be more scattered with the heavier across the country and in the Texas Panhandle, and regardless much of the southern plains will have a stormy few days. A mid-level threat will continue to move over the west coast by Thursday night and Friday, and this will bring showers from northern California and the British Columbia. The precipitation in northern California will diminish by Friday morning, and however, the Pacific Northwest could still see some showers on Friday, but will dry out in the evening. And high pressure will begin to build over the northeast and New England on Thursday night. In the wake of the cold front pushing offshore and clear skies, and light winds will settle over the area and bringing cold temperatures overnight. A frost advisory and freeze warning have been issued for the northeast and the New England tonight and beyond the front moving toward the Great Lakes and Friday night, bring cooler fall-like conditions to the area.
And the San Edward is now a tropical storm with 70 mph. Wind gusts with it moving east about 17 mph and center location 39.9 to north, 39.2 to the west. And the latest advisory on Edward here, it's still a strong tropical storm here. There are no coast watch warning effect as of 11 p.m. Atlantic time, 3 a.m. UTC. The center of tropical storm Edward was located near latitude 39.9 to north, longitude 39.2 to the west. Edward is moving toward the northeastern 17 mph/20 km/h and a slow eastward motion is expected over the next day, so followed by a turn to the southeast. Max sustained winds near 70 mph, remaining at 1 to 10 km/h, with our best weakening expected to be during the next 48 hours. And Edward is forecast to become a post-tropical cyclone by Friday night. Tropical plus winds extend out to up to 2 to 5 miles, 3 to 35 kilometers from the center, and estimated minimum center pressure 98 millibars, 28 to 94 inches. Here, and let's take a look at forecast discussion around. Service number one here. It's a broad area of low pressure associated with a tropical wave is located just off the west coast of Africa, and shines and central activity is currently in disorganized. And the development of the system should be slow to occur while it moves slowly west northwestward to the northwest over the Asian tropical land during the next several days. Formation chance 4 hours. Low 10% formation chance 5 days. Low 20%. And let's take a look at our Eastern Pacific outlook here. The latest on Tropical Storm Polo here, with a wind 70 mph, moving northwest about 9 mph, and central location 18.4 to north, 106.6 west, as 11 p.m. advisory here. And it's local advisory on Polo here. It's Tropical Storm Watch issued for Southern Baja California, and the governor of Mexico is issued a Tropical Storm Watch for the Southern Baja California Peninsula from Santa Fe to La Paz. Southern Watch is a warning effect. The Tropical Storm warning is effect for Punta San Telmo to Playa Perilla, and a tropical storm watch in effect for west of Playa Perilla to Cabo Grande. Southern Baja California Peninsula from Santa Fe to La Paz. And first storm information specific to your area, please monitor products issued by a local National Meteorological Service. At 8 p.m. Pacific time, the UTC, the central tropical storm Polo was located at latitude 18.4 to north, longitude 106.6 west, and Polo is moving toward the northwest near 9 miles by 15 km. And this is Joe Bolshit, it was with a decrease in port speed that is expected over the next 48 hours. And in the forecast track, the center will continue to move parallel to the western coast of Mexico for tonight and some of the Baja California Peninsula by Saturday. However, any deviation in the north of the track could bring stronger winds to the coast to southern Baja California. Max same winds in Maine near 70 miles per 1 to 10 km/h with higher gusts. Low change of surface is likely overnight, but a gradual weakening trend should begin on Friday. And tropical storm force wind extends up to 1 to 50 miles, 185 km from the center. That's when the minimum center pressure is 91 millibars or 20.97 inches here. And as effect the land, tropical storm conditions are likely to occur in over the portions of the border area. Tropical storm conditions are possible within watch area in the mainland Mexico tonight. Tropical storm conditions are possible within watch area in southern Baja California on Sunday. And surface swells are generated by a polar wave effect. Portions of the southern coast of Mexico during the next few days, and swells are likely to cause life-threatening and surfing with current conditions. Please consult products issued for your local weather office. Rainfall polar is expected to produce additional rainfall amounts of 2 to 4 inches with isolated storm. Total rainfall amounts of 10 to 15 inches near the coast of Colima, Navarre, and Jalisco states in Mexico, and these rains could result in life-threatening and flash floods and mudslides. And let's take a look at public advisory. Let's take a look at Central Pacific Tropical Outlook. North and Bruna in Central Pacific here. And take a look at our forecast discussion around the country here. Now around the nation. Take a look at forecast discussion around the region here. A weak, dry, cold front will cross the area this evening as cold, high pressure builds into New England tonight and Friday. Some frost may form across portions of southern New England and southern New Hampshire late tonight. The high will drift offshore throughout the weekend, resulting in a brief return to mild temperatures. A cold front moves from early Monday, followed by cool weather toward the middle of next week. SFC observations suggest that the weakening cold front is currently about 20-30 SM from the south coast. Winds have picked up the western pressure across much of the northern and eastern half of the region, sustaining at about 10 knots an hour. Do continue to note that skies have already cleared across the northwest and it continues to dissipate even across 70 and eastern portions of the forecast area. Some deeper valleys in the New York Vermont all are showing calm conditions, latest mesoscale guidance supports that this decoupling is continuing to expand toward the southeast as southern portions of southern New Hampshire and northwest Massachusetts may also still decouple fully. Later on, the report feels that the current timing and placement of the frost advisory look to be reasonable and have just the temperatures 2 points to better match. This thinking of our updated skies to reflect tip winds and leftover lower curve weatherness from the frontal passage here. Take a look at what an upset on this late Thursday night. A glorious Thursday was on tap today. It was beautiful. Highs were in the 60s to the 70s, but it's going to be much cooler on Friday and be a frost fret. And it'll be a warmer weekend. Saturday we'll see 70. Sunday, 77 around 80 degrees. And at water temperature, 62 degrees and 40 more in lows. Inland will be 37 and 46 and Cape Town 45 and 50. And that's why.
There's a frost advisory for much of northern New England, except for the seacoast region of New Hampshire, from Manchester down to Portsmouth Fair. And we got a freeze warning up in the air right next to New York State here. And we get up in the morning. Oh my, look at this. 35 degrees in Concord, New Hampshire. 35 for Rutland, Vermont. 40 in Albany, New York. 44 in Worcester. 49 out in Boston. 47 out in Hartford. And 55 in New York City. So. Moms and dads, better bundle up your kids at the bus stop tomorrow morning because it is going to be a frigid morning in town. Beer. And let's take a look at tomorrow's high. It is going to be a cool day in tap for tomorrow with temperatures ranging from 58 to Boston to 67 New York City, 65 in Hartford, 59 in Worcester, 63 in Albany, 60 in Concord, New Hampshire, 58 in Portland, Maine, and 59 in Rutland, Vermont. So, tomorrow's temperature range for tomorrow will be 58 to 67 degrees. There. So, take a look. 7 day forecast goes like this. While you're sleeping in overnight hours tonight, most of the coast guard with a low of 45 degrees. North wind about 8 miles per hour. Friday, sun sky to news 62 degrees. North wind about 10 to 14 miles per hour. Friday night, coast guard low of 39 degrees east. Wind about 5 miles per hour. Coming in the evening. So if you're going to high school football games, including the Norton Lancers high school football game against Midfield, you better bundle up because it is going to be chilly as I'm going to go to Norton High to cheer on my Lancers here. For Saturday, sun sky under 69 degrees and calm wind becoming 7 about 5 to 9 miles by the afternoon. Saturday night, punch above after 1 a.m. was. Podcast got a low 55 degrees and southward about 5 to 7 miles per hour. For Sunday, punch above before 9 a.m. was. Most of the sun sky under 70 degrees and if you're going to the Patriots game at Gillette Stadium against the Oakland Raiders for the 2014 Patriots home opener is going to be perfect football weather, 78 degrees. Sunday night, check the showers after 11 p.m. Most of the low 56 degrees and check the patients 30%. Monday, most of the sun sky under 72 degrees. Monday night, most of the sun low 45 degrees. Tuesday, most of the sun sky under 68 degrees. Tuesday night, most of the sun low 46 degrees. Wednesday, sun sky under 66 degrees. Wednesday night, most of the sun low 43 degrees. And for Thursday, sun sky under 69 degrees. There's what a phrase on the night. A freezing Friday morning in store and a chilly Friday in store. This is PJ with us. We have a good night with a good positive. I'll be looking forward to seeing you tomorrow morning. Good night.